One imposes far too many limitations on art when one demands that only well-ordered, morally balanced souls may express themselves in it. As in the plastic arts, so in music and poetry too, there is an art of the ugly soul beside the art of the beautiful soul. And the mightiest effects of art, that which tames souls, moves stones, and humanizes the beast, have perhaps been mostly achieved by precisely that art.